So, hello guys, I'm at Farad's power supplies and I will show you the production and let's see what's going on here. I say hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Welcome.
Welcome
to Farad.
Yeah.
Power supplies in Netherlands.
Yeah.
So this is where we built them. So we can go. We can look there. It's, it's a place where people are working. Normally.
Normally, yes.
Yeah. It's a free day today. So we get in all the parts from all around the world. It comes here, and then people are. Putting everything together,
yeah,
and then it comes to me and I can check everything, and after the first check and the first
some secrets here, or can I
no
film?
It's no secrets, we don't have secrets. We
okay.
just build good stuff and people can get it,
okay,
and they build it into the enclosures,
yeah,
and after that it comes back to me again where I can test and finalize it, program it, and then it goes to the testing area.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, nice. So it's some in production, and so already we are really working in advance at this moment, because it's really hard to get parts.
Yeah,
and so we stocked up a little for the next months.
Yeah,
no, it's I think this is for about half a year.
Okay,
and it's about 400 pieces at this moment in production.
Okay,
and we also start with, of course, the new Super 10.
Super 10,
it's
yeah.
So it's also starting to in production, and like the chokes and the enclosures and the PCBs. Old prototypes are still there. It's all casted and shielded. So we don't have any EMC inside of the supply, and it keeps really clean.
Yeah. So after that
we go to the
okay.
the place where it's where it's tested. So we have here my building area and the testing area, and also where I design everything.
Ah, that's your working place.
That's my working place.
Yeah.
And we're already also doing the orders here. And within some months somebody else comes here, and then that the next office will be my office, and we have some extra people because
okay.
they're really busy, especially with the Super 10. After they are built, they are put on our testing devices. I don't know the right word.
Yeah. And how you test them?
They're dynamically tested. So these testers on the Super 3 put on 0 to 3 amperes every second. It changes, so it's 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 0, 3, 1.5, 3.5, oh, no, not 3.5, and so it's really tested to the max.
They have to work.
They have to work hard,
yeah.
and they
yeah.
get really hot. And when they survive that, they will also survive the normal.
At
area.
The customer,
and
at
they
home.
Also break in a little.
Yeah,
the first day. So Super 3 is 1 day testing. Super 10 is gets a bit more testing because it's. It's really sensitive for breaking in, so
okay,
we put them a bit longer on the testing bench.
And what is so special for Farad power supplies? What is one of your not secrets, but one of your
the secret is not great specs,
yeah,
but we do a lot of listening. And specs, of course, also really important, but many people do not realize, and that's one of my frustrations, they're always running after regulators,
yeah,
and regulated circuits. But a regulated circuit does only maybe 10% of what is done in a power supply. Like, a power supply needs to be clean from 0 to hundreds of megahertz.
Okay.
A regulator can only work up to maybe 100 kilohertz, or not higher. So what do you do above?
Yeah, okay.
That's really important.
Okay.
And it only damps 60 dB. And we want to have 120 dB or something like that.
Okay.
So there's a big area around the regulator, which is in many brands do not fill in. They just focus on the regulator.
Yeah.
But a good supply is not just the regulator. It's built up from the front. Good transformer, good good rectification,
yeah.
A lot of HF filtering, star ground, star voltage also,
oh, yeah.
Everything. And the main feature of each Farad is that it has supercapacitors, and supercapacitors are capacitors with a lot of capacity, which means we have a double regulation, mm-hmm. so also much more filtering. The first regulation charges the supercaps, and the second regulation works from that supercap voltage, which is really stable and clean already,
mm-hmm.
and only needs to do the right voltage to the output. And because the supercaps are so, you have typical around 1 farad, or in the, maybe like in the Super 10, up to 16 farads. So
okay.
We're talking not about microfarads, but 16 million of microfarads.
Okay.
So it's a lot of capacitors. It's like a virtual battery.
Yeah.
The nice thing is that that regulator can only go that way. They can only push power into that because it's backed
okay.
by really stable, clean power already.
Okay,
so you get a really clean, solid output power to the output, and it gives a really high bandwidth, very high damped clean power supply.
But tell your customers, how long do they have to wait for best performance with your power supplies?
Yeah, that's the problem. we talked about it some time ago. They really need braking. There's two kinds of braking in the farad supplies. The first is when you put on power, it really needs a few days to settle,
yes.
because everything needs to be balanced.
Yeah.
And the second is the braking in, and this can take really, yeah. You can hear. I always say you can hear the improvement right away, over an SMPS or another supply. Oh, mostly it's right away is much better. But
okay.
after that, it only starts, maybe drops a little, and then it starts to get better even. And that can take up to 300 or 500 hours. It goes and goes and goes.
It keeps improving. Better and better and better.
Yeah,
and the sound stays
really nice.
Yeah, that's
so
nice.
The first initial improvement is already fine. And then I have to say, like the voltages you see are not really representative. It's a Chinese cheap measurement. So... also, the change in voltage, sometimes people say, oh, it's changing a lot. It's much more stable in practice. But
okay.
it has to do with the cabling and everything in the test.
Sure, it's
so,
a system and
every
detail is important.
For me, it's just that I can see, I see right away if it's okay or not. That's the only thing I need to see, not
okay.
the exact voltage, because I already measured that in the testing. So, and after this test, they get back again with me, and I test everything again, and then we clean it up, pack it, and then it can be shipped.
Okay, so are you sure your customers are satisfied?
Yeah, that's where we go for.
Okay.
Not only in sound, but also.
The customer
nice...
must be calm and waiting for best performance, and so plug in and better sound than an SPS, but burn in time and filling up the caps.
It will be better. Yeah,
wonderful.
So.
Okay, let's start. Maybe another room, if you want.
Yeah, this is it.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not...
yeah, okay.
I don't... I'm still...
you said you can go...
Yeah,
go
okay, but that's not really...
Okay.
Like this room will be my next... Yeah, but... It's I'm still building it. I'm
Ooh.
Also the designer of Pink Foam equipment.
That was my question for
No, I really love high sensitivity speakers and speed and everything. So I'm I didn't have a system for I think about 7 or 6 years, because I really I was always listening to errors and improving things.
Mm-hmm.
So I finally decided I need a system again, and then I started to buy things. But I still have to finish everything. So it's just parts now, but it will be our new, for Farad, one of our new references, I have to say. Because what we do at Farad, we have about 4 people with different systems, with different tastes. And that's why we do the listening sessions. So we get a new product, we goes to all those people. So it's audited in not only one system, but in all those systems with different people, difference. And one is with Goldmund and forget the brand. The other one is with Pinkfong and Harbert, and there's one with MSB and I don't know all the brands, but
yeah, but different.
It's a lot of different systems with different, and if it sounds everywhere like we want to,
the improvement is really nearly the same.
It's not just clean. It's also what we really are aiming for is organicity. I don't know. Organic sound.
Organic sound.
Okay. So it's not just perfect and you hear everything, but also very smooth, natural musicality.
Because that's
in the end, after the first impression of the what we call tingle tangle has been gone, then you start to listen to musicality.
Yeah.
And musicality is what counts. You have to be on the couch and want to stay there.
Stay there.
Because you want to hear more.
Yes.
And more and more.
Yes.
And that's what we're
It's like
for.
A drug. The music is then the drug and you will
and
stay
there. And a good system
there.
Does that.
Yes.
Pulls you into the music and keeps you into the music.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, and that's what we are with not only with Farad but also with Pinkfong. That's really what to aim for.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, many thanks for these words.
Yeah, thank you.
And
also for your visit.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.